podcast present by Spy News Agency. Oh, Biden, what have you done? Remember the iconic image of a smiling Joe Biden in his 1967 Corvette Stingray? It conjured charming Uncle Joe, a retro cool guy who'd been around the track and knew how to handle it. For months after President Biden called Donald Trump's mishandling of classified documents irresponsible, that vintage car, parked at the president's home in Delaware next to his own boxes containing classified material, has been transformed into a shiny symbol of hypocrisy. If you went into a GOP whataboutism lab and asked for a perfect gaffe, you'd come out with the president snapping last week to a Fox News reporter, "My Corvette is in a locked garage." Well, the storage room at Mar-a-Lago is locked, too. Just 2 weeks ago, Democrats were chortling over chaos in the GOP, convinced that far-right Republican control of the House would help them in 2024. Then they experienced the exquisite torture that comes with the slow release of politically damaging information, in this case the acknowledgement of classified documents found in Mr. Biden's former offices and Wilmington home. Now he's fully in the barrel, targeted by powerful congressional committees, aggressive reporters looking for scoops, and a methodical new special counsel, Robert Hur, to match Jack Smith, the special counsel investigating Mr. Trump. The optical equivalence between Mr. Trump and Mr. Biden is phony, of course. Mr. Trump is a grifter who appears to have intentionally taken hundreds of classified documents, bragging that he kept the folders marked classified or confidential as cool keepsakes. He said of his stash of classified documents, according to several advisors, "It's not theirs, it's mine," and seemingly defied a subpoena to return the documents, thereby exposing him to possible prosecution for obstruction of justice. Mr. Biden, by contrast, was sloppy and slow to search for and disclose the existence of about 20 stray classified documents, but is fully cooperating with authorities. Unfortunately for Mr. Biden, this distinction cannot easily survive the miasma of congressional and special counsel subpoenas, relentless questions from reporters, and fresh allegations of impropriety that signal the arrival of a new episodic political drama. Many voters with better things to do with their time than parse the nuances of presidential record-keeping may casually conclude that both men are careless, lying politicians. On one level, the classified documents imbroglio is just an acrimonious prelude to the 2024 campaign, a story that will surface, disappear, then surface again with tiresome predictability. But Mr. Biden's new problems run deeper than that. They represent both a challenge to his core political brand of honor and decency, and the start of a more intense, potentially combative period of scrutiny for a president poised to seek re-election. All of which suggests that we may look back on January of 2023 as the end of a relatively brief era in American political life, a period, for all its turmoil, when two Democratic presidents avoided being enmeshed in the grinding machinery of scandal that has otherwise characterized Washington for half a century. All 10 American presidencies since 1973 have faced investigation by a special counsel or independent prosecutor, except one, Barack Obama's. For 8 years, Mr. Obama and his vice president and other high-ranking officials were seen as figures of unusual rectitude, and the impression of integrity returned when Mr. Biden took office after 4 years of wall-to-wall corruption. But now this sharp ethical contrast with Mr. Trump has been dulled. That complicates the president's expected re-election campaign, and could even short-circuit it. Most Democrats still think Mr. Biden is honest, and they view his accomplishments on the economy, climate, infrastructure, and defending democracy as far more significant than this lapse. But it's hard to exaggerate the level of Democratic exasperation with him for squandering a huge political advantage on the Mar-a-Lago story and for muddying what may have been the best chance to convict Mr. Trump on federal charges. Mr. Biden's more serious problem may be with independents, whom he carried by 9 points in 2020. Unforced errors can take a toll with them. Even as the classified documents story eventually fades, it will most likely not be a first-tier issue next year. Swing voters may see him in a harsher light.